Hey, what's going on? So anyways, it's one of those day and nights. Nothing fancy. Maybe one day I'll feel youthful and whatever and do like a good looking view. But I don't know, I'm getting old as hell these days. Everything's falling apart, or things are growing that I don't want to grow, or whatever the case is. But it's, what is it, March the 10th, 2018. What time is it? 11:21. 11:21 p.m. Yeah, I don't. My memory is all screwed up, so I can't really remember a lot. But I know today hasn't really been a good day. Last night I probably crashed out around anywhere from 2 to 4, 5, 6 o'clock. I don't know what it was. But, yeah. I was doing good for the most part last night. Just I don't know, I just started to feel not good though. So I was just like listening to music and doing some coloring. I don't really color. But I was like trying to do something. Like I've been trying to work on like learning about the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system, the autonomic nervous system, to be exact. So I know mine's screwed up. But, oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, yesterday I made some. Actually, I think I still got some. I got a. Oh, wow, I left a lot. Oh, that's great. I really gotta wash that out before bugs and fermentation kicks in. But yeah, I made some coconut. Not coconut, but cucumber water, essentially. I was drinking that. It was weird because I was like feeling really screwed up and everything. Yesterday, I don't remember everything. Like I said, memory issues. But I was like, I don't know. I drank it and then all of a sudden I just like, whoa. Like it was, things were like a thousand times different. It was weird. It was almost like getting a shot of magnesium or something, or I don't know. It was crazy. But yeah, I was, I don't think I really had much food yesterday. I don't really remember what I had. Well, I mean, if I think about it, I guess I do, but nothing fancy. So, yeah, I just pretty much somewhat coloring. I was playing this racing drift game on my phone, which apparently you can actually, if you log on or do whatever, you can play other people. Fake money, but you can play other people around the world. Which is pretty cool. But yeah, it was all that, and then I just kind of started to feel, I don't know, whatever, but I crashed out. I woke up today around 11:30-ish or so. I've been pretty much just laying around all day. But I was like sleeping, and I noticed like the back of my head, I was like, oh. Fuck, what the hell? Like, I don't know, like I've kind of had that before, sort of, but nothing that intense. Specifically, it pretty much happened the whole day, but it felt like the back of my neck was numb. Well, not the neck, but my head. It was almost like a numb feeling. Which I don't know. It's probably the same feeling, but later on, like when I got up, I noticed I may have, I don't really remember what the hell I did. I gotta really think about it. But I remember I got up, I think I did whatever, but yeah, I started to notice like I wasn't feeling well and took my blood pressure and was like 120 over 94, and my pulse was 100 over 100, I think it was like 122. So, yeah, maybe I was up for a while, I don't know. But I noticed like every time I got up, I just I felt overwhelmed. I just kind of felt like I was gonna pass out or whatever, in a weird way, not like a lightheaded way, which I have been getting lightheaded a lot today. But yeah, just having all these issues, I'm like, what the hell, dude? But yeah, you know, like, oh, I'm trying not to think about it. I kind of have this thing I could think about stuff, and it comes into fruition. But it's kind of like memories, like you can smell something and you're like, it can be so real, you know what I mean? But God, I'm trying not to think about it, and I can feel it right now. But it's like the best prime example, the best example I can come up with is like when you do a handstand. I don't know if you guys has ever done, like, you know, handstand, like, you know, your head. So you're like that. This is my head, like that, but it's hands. So, and you get all that, I guess it's like a head rush in a sense, but you get that, all that pressure and just all that. So that's what it's been doing all day. It was doing it when I was laying down. Every time I lay down, it's kind of doing it now. I'm kind of wondering if it's because I'm leaning on this, but pretty much all day. And then a little bit ago, it kind of stopped, which is weird because I'm wondering if it's my spine, because I'm starting to get it again. That's weird. I'm wondering if it is my spine, because I was fine, and now I don't know. Maybe it's my thought process or something. But it's starting to come back now. What the fuck? I don't know. Maybe it's just the way that I'm... Maybe me laying down or something. It could be that. It could be me laying down, because I had it, like, I got it a lot when I was laying down. Strange. But I think whatever it is, I think it's a manifestation of poor digestion. I think that there's really something going on in my digestion. So I don't know. I just know that I've had all kinds of different things happen. All kinds of inflammations, and my spleen's still enlarged. I think it's like 12 centimeters or whatever. Oh wow. My like right here, my upper right quadrant side. It's funny because I was my ex a few weeks ago or whatever. She was looking at my stomach, like right here, and she's like, "Oh wow, that's enlarged or swollen." I was like, "Yeah," and that's the crazy thing, because the last couple of years I've been having pain there. But you go to the doctors or whatever and they don't do nothing. But I do know I had a ultrasound or something like that, I believe, at the hospital, because I thought I had a heart attack last year, June or so of last year, which I guess I didn't, but they said that I was having either I had polyps or I had cholesterol deposits. So I'm assuming cholesterol deposits are stones. But yeah, the upper right quadrant side, I've been having a lot of pain there. Not lately. It happens, but not lately. But yeah, I just found out when I got another ultrasound, me and my ex went, well, at the time, went to the hospital, and they got it done, whatever, and it came back that I had fatty liver. Well, it's strange, because like two months prior, I had a MRI that checked everything, and nobody said anything. So, but then again, I don't really know if an MRI looks for it, but I've had tons of ultrasounds in the past. Never really ever shows anything. So I think it is kind of strange, because I would say in the last, you know, and the crazy thing is the the piece of shit physician that I was seeing, and she never seemed to do anything. Under her watch, under her care, or now after the fact, you know, I gained 74 pounds in 2.5 years, to the point that I gained so much weight, like all this, I gained so much, I have stretch marks like here and here. I'll have that for the rest of my life. Even if I get abs or whatever. I have what they call lipomas. Now, I don't have like the freaking huge lipomas. But it's like, lipomas is like, I guess when you get like a, I guess it's usually what it is. Like a lot of weight gain or whatever. And you get these little bumps and stuff. These bumps can get freaking huge, man. But yeah. But if they do, or if they become bothersome, you have to get surgery to remove them, which there's no cures. And yeah, it hurts either way you look at it. So breathing issues. It's like that cool breathing, but it's not like cool breathing. It's like cool. I don't know. It's just, huh. It's kind of like you're talking a lot. You kind of run out of breath. Kind of wondering if it's a little better now. Maybe it is my neck. Maybe it is my spine. Because I feel like this has kind of gone away. Oh, speaking of cool, I'm starting to feel cool again. I don't know. I was at my desk a little bit, about a couple hours ago, or whatever it was, and all of a sudden I just started to feel like really cool and very clammy, and my vitals started to get crazy. So I actually got high. I don't know. My vitals, I think I talked about it. Like I said, I can't really keep track of what I'm talking about right now. But yeah, my vitals are kind of like all over the place. Like one second they could be like 120 over 94, pulse 122. Then they could be like 140 over 80 or whatever, and pulse is 70 or 80s. Or it could be like 124, or yeah, like 135 over 77, no, 72, and your pulse is like 103, and it's just like, I don't know, I've been having a lot of issues. I'm not gonna try to make this too long. It's just crazy how fast time actually goes. But yeah, I don't know if I showed you this. I know I did like a video. Yeah, it kind of looks like a beeper, huh? So that little green button. So that this is called a heart event monitor. So they want me to wear this for 7 days. So, and if I have like any sensation, palpitations, lightheadedness, dizziness, whatever the case is. And it goes deep, deep, deep. And then I guess it shuts off like after 10, 15 seconds. Which is crazy because when they were doing it last time, it was like a freaking minute. I'm just like, oh my goodness. So, I don't know. I don't really know if 10 seconds is long enough. I mean, a lot of things can happen in 10 seconds. See, I think it's my spine. Was I talking about my autonomic nervous system? See, because I was just making a freaking video and I don't even remember. But yeah, I've been trying to learn about my autonomic nervous system. So, I don't know. I just know I'm screwed. I don't know what I'm saying. Like, my thought process, like my memory, like I can't remember anything. I don't know, like, okay, autonomic nervous system, sympathetic, parasympathetic, sympathetic, it's kind of like, a seesaw. So basically, it can never be like this. So your sympathetic, which is your fight or flight, and then you have your parasympathetic, which is like rest and digest. So your sympathetic is going to raise your blood pressure, it's going to raise your pulse, it's going to cause like all kinds of stuff going on. Your parasympathetic actually calms everything down. So your autonomic nervous system is kind of like your wash on, wash off, your yin yang, which also controls, you know, all this. So, you know, all your subconscious stuff, your involuntary muscles, like your heart and everything else that keeps you alive. But sometimes there can be dysregulations and it can really screw you up. So that's what I'm trying to learn. I'm trying to learn like meditations, and like I want to start trying to do biofeedback. I saw this, I don't know what it's called, but it's like some type of band or something that you can buy, but you put it on your head and I guess it can read the brain waves in your head, and you, I guess you have like a phone and you download the app, and it can kind of like measure stuff, like say if you're depressed or however you feel, you can just kind of like whatever, and I don't know, it's like a biofeedback thing. I was like, that is so freaking cool. I forgot what it's called. I think it's like $200-$300. I was like, dude, that's pretty freaking cool though. Actually, that'd be pretty cool if I could take something like this, take this out, put it in there, put it with the program, instead of having to, you know, but have something like with wires and just put it on my head instead of the, because it's just too damn expensive. Yeah, there's so much stuff I want to talk about. I'm just practically rambling now. What was I talking about? You know, I've been ranting for like 17 minutes about practically the same thing, or basically what I kind of wanted to talk about, which is probably going to be a lot shorter, and it's pretty much redundant pretty much about what I want to talk about. It's pretty much all in my videos is physicians. So, I'm not going to say everything, but I used to, when I first got sick in October of 2004, I usually say November, but I started to get sick in October. That's when I started to notice symptoms. It was mid to late October 2004. So, I don't know, this place I was going to, February the 2nd, 2015 was when I went, and I was going there for about 9 months. It was one of those places, if you didn't have money, hey, they'll help you out. It's like a charity place. And at that time I didn't know anything about health. I didn't know shit. I didn't know that 150/119 pulse 132 was bad. Like, I would be laying here. Not here, different town, but I'd be laying here. I'd take my blood pressure. Just waking up, and it'd be, I don't know what my blood pressure, but I know the diastolic started at 94. Just laying down, my diastolic was 94. But yeah, that was pretty bad. And then when I got up, it started to, like I was even riding my bicycle and stuff at that point, but I was pretty screwed up. Oh my God. I think it is. It's when I lay down, I'm good. When I sit up, oh, I don't know. But yeah, but the place that I went to, they automatically said that I was a hypochondriac, that I was making stuff up, that I was too young, definitely all those. Making stuff up, I have been told that before. That I have anxiety, that I'm, you know, whatever. I'm just like, no, bro. Like, I'm having symptoms of, like, sepsis. Like, I was looking stuff up, and you know what? Maybe I did have sepsis. I don't know. But I did tell him, I was like, hey, look, I'm having symptoms of gastritis. They fucking ignore me. They just, oh, you're blah, 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 blah. You know, the funny thing is a couple years later, when I went to a hospital and they finally did an upper and lower GI, which I had to convince about the lower GI, which that's, ugh. But, found out not only that I have gastritis, but gastritis, esophagitis, polyp in the stomach, internal hemorrhoids, yeah. yeah. So, that's what I had. When I first got sick and I was having a cranial headache, I mean, like, just a skull ache. I don't know. Like, cranial headaches, like those type, are like the worst on the planet. Like, you can't have anything worse besides actually somebody just. But the best way I can describe it is take a cold shower. Specifically, like, literally cold, like, it's cold outside, cold water, and just let that shit on your head, and your nerves will, like, ice up, essentially, and you will experience some pretty bad pain. Like, I remember that, but I remember I went there, and they were like, oh, you just got anxiety, and they gave me, blood pressure medication. I don't know what all the ones were, but I remember one was Toprol XL, about 25 milligrams. Actually, I still got the bottle 14 years later. It's, well, 13 years later. But, well, almost 13, I guess. Oh, yeah. But, I don't know. I don't know why I got it. But yeah, they were just like, you know, blah, 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 blah. And I mean, it helped, but it got to the point that I was taking this blood pressure medication. And I'm just, you know, my blood pressure was still like 140 over whatever. I mean, I don't really know what my normal blood pressure was. I know when I was a kid, it was like 135 over, I don't know. But I do know that my pulse was going from like 132, and was dropping down to like 50, like literally 50. And I was having breathing problems, shortness of breath and stuff, and they're just like, you know, they're like, well, you control your own blood pressure medication. You do what you think is best. You're giving me blood pressure medication. You're telling me to control the fucking dosages. By the way, this specific group, at least back then, they would literally go to the library and get blood pressure medication books. Literally. I know this because I overheard them. It's just like a lot of the people, they didn't know how to fucking take blood pressure. They didn't know how to read a pulse. They didn't know how to feel for a pulse. They were usually using like the pump ones where you put it like the cuffs to go ch-ch-ch-ch. Yeah, that. But yeah, they did tons of tests, and tests came back left and right abnormal. Like CBC, CMP, I'd have like 10 things abnormal. You know, like high, or low. But they always said, oh, you're fine, there's nothing wrong. And that was kind of like the cycle. I mean, I went to the hospitals prior, but I remember when my blood sugar was like 32. 30 fucking 2, man. My mom made me like a gallon of OJ. 4 liters. Yeah. Of OJ. And my sugar was only 70-something when we got to the hospital. You're like, oh, well, you just have hypoglycemia. You need to eat complex carbs. I don't know. I just know I went to the vending machine. I guess I paid out of my pocket. I don't know. I had the best fucking awesomest sandwich in the world. I don't know what it is. Was. I don't know. I just know it was in one of those vending machines. The ones where you, with the turntable, you know, each one, and it has like different stuff in there. God, I don't know. I gotta go find one of those. That was like the freaking bestest. Like, I can still remember it now. But yeah, just like, I was puking all kinds of bile up. Like, I was puking tons of bile. Like 16 ounces of bile. And just like, at a time. Not like, bleh, 16, then bleh, 16, then bleh. But yeah, I was puking a lot. Like, I was really sick. And they blew me off. I remember when I would come to the San Antonio hospitals and stuff. Like, they would just blow me off. Just like, oh, you're a hypochondriac. I remember one time, like, my pulse was a minimum of 140. It was even going down. And I was having, I don't know, but I saw this one. I don't remember what hospital it was, but I remember I came in and somebody was like, oh, poor baby, your hands, you're dehydrated. Which is funny because you look right now, you can't really see anything. Well, sometimes if I got up, you could. I'm kind of tucked in right now. Oh, that's funny. But yeah, they're like, oh, you're dehydrated, and they got me some saline and helped me a little bit, but over the last all these years, that's usually all they do, and that's, if you're lucky, they may give you saline. I've had sepsis, I've had renal failure, well, close to it. They gave me vancomycin in 2009 for that one. Like, my stuff was bad. Like, I'm thinking my white blood cells, I don't know, I just had to test them. All right, blood cells like 4, so I'm just like, ugh. So according to their thing, I'm kind of, ugh, low. So even though it's kind of been 6, around 6 lately. But I've been giving a lot of blood too, so not like I'm trying to. It's just they're doing a lot of blood tests. So, but yeah, it's just basically like you go to all these hospitals. You're having like all these issues, and they're just like, you got anxiety, you're making things up, blah 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 blah, you're looking for attention. But yeah, like I remember this one hospital that I've gone to, which is funny because I have like 4 or 5 medical records from like the previous visits, like the different providers, doctors or whatever. But they all got records, by the way. But yeah, I remember, like, I would see this one guy, and I remember I wasn't feeling good, I was feeling sick, and this little faggot-ass, queer bitch-ass motherfucker, oh my god, if I found that motherfucker, fucking faggot. But, no, like, that dude was a piece of shit. I saw him one time, at another place, but I wasn't feeling good, so, you know, I really wasn't feeling good. Because if I was feeling good, I'd probably beat the fuck out of his ass. Well, I'd break bones. But, yeah, I remember, like, how that was, like, after I found out the gastritis and esophagitis and all that other stuff. And the guy was just yelling at me, saying, you don't have any of that, blah, 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 blah. Motherfucker. A hospital fucking went up my boot toe, you know, blip, and found that stuff. But, that guy, I think, was prior to it. I don't know. It was some occasion. I don't remember. I've been through so much crap. But it was, what was it? It was, because I get very paranoid about IVs and people putting different weird shit in there. So, and at first he was like, oh, so well, you're just going to deny the treatment? Or, yeah, you're going to deny the treatment? I was like, yeah, I don't want it. Okay, well, I'll let the doctor know and we'll just send you home. First of all, motherfucker, I got the right to deny whatever the fuck I want. Doesn't mean you're supposed to just stop. But, I don't know, he was saying something that was like, it was a sedative, or it was something, I don't know, it was something called Fenirken. I don't know, that's how I say it. But, I took it. I don't know, I think it's like a sedative type medication, but I think it helps with the pain or nausea, or I don't remember, something. And he put it in me. Now that fucking sounds gay. He injected the Fenirken into the IV line. And they took off, and then 5-10 minutes, I don't know, but I was like this, but 1,000 times worse. I literally did not know what the fuck I was doing. I didn't know anything. But I was kinda agitated too. I remember I was like, if anybody comes in here, I'm gonna beat the fuck out of them. I don't know. I didn't say that to anybody, but when they came in, I was like, oh my God, dude, I'm tripping. Like, I'm having issues. Like, I think at that point I was crying. I was just like, what the fuck? And then the piece of shit physician came in and was literally yelling at me, saying that I was just looking for attention, that I was just fine, that there was nothing wrong with me. And then they fucking threw me out. Said if I didn't leave the premises, or if I didn't leave, yeah, they threw me out. And then the fucking rent-a-cop was like, if you don't get off the premises, I'm going to call SAPD and get a trespassing violation or whatever. I'm just like, what the fuck, dude? But yeah, I mean, in that time, like, that's a fucking lawsuit. A doctor or a fucking piece of shit just injecting you with something. You're in a confused state. You don't know what the fuck you're doing from 10 to 2. Luckily, you've had a lot of drug experiences, and you've been able to get home. And by the way, I didn't live in this city. I lived not close. Walking would have took forever. But luckily, I called this one guy that I knew, my family knows. And he picked me up. But yeah, it was terrible. Like, I don't know if that guy's even, I don't know, like, I kind of wonder if I, like, because I have a filing cabinet. The fuck? You got a filing cabinet? Bro, like, is your filing cabinet full of medical records? I would say altogether, if it was, well, I don't know, because I have like 800, 1,000 pages on CD, so I would say altogether, maybe, if it was just like regular, all paper, everything, it'd probably fill up two drawers, and they're the big drawers too. They're not like big, but they're, yeah. It's a lot of paperwork. Now I'm just kind of wondering if that guy's still, I don't know. But no, it really pisses me off. Like, I've had all these bad experiences in these doctors. No accountability. Providers, no accountability. They just do whatever the fuck they want to do. They don't care. You know, like, what I was trying to basically say earlier, well, what was kind of my original thing was, you know, I'm sick right now. I'm hooked up to this thing, and I got all kinds of shit going on. And it's like, you go to the doctors, which they charge you a fuckload of money. The chick that I was seeing prior slit that bitch's throat. But I was seeing was charging like $207 a visit. That doesn't count anything else. I'm just like, wow. And she'd only see you for like 5-10 minutes. And basically everything that was of relevance, it's, well, that's not significant. Or it's unremarkable. I'm just like, huh. Oh, I also have brain disease now because of that. I'm not saying this because of her, but I kept telling people for 4 fucking years. 6 years or however long it was. Well, basically, like, 8 years. Well, sort of. So I just had a PET scan, finally, because nobody ever wanted to do it. But my new neurologist that does, like, Alzheimer's and dementia and shit like that found out that my brain, my temporal lobes, they're fucked up, like, bad. They're not, like, insane bad, but they're, significant issues. That, the occipital lobe, there was a few other spots. My temporal lobes, not temporal, frontal lobe, is pretty good for activity, for the, the glucose, when they do the PET scan. But functioning, like, if you do, like, because I've had EEGs and it always comes back pretty bad. It's like moderate to severe cognitive impairment type shit. I've had, like, 3 different psych tests, psychological tests. You know, the ones that make you really feel stupid? Where it's like you're a genius and know everything? Even then? And then some of them, like the Minnesota test, it's not geared to see if you're crazy or not. It's geared to see what type of crazy you are. But yeah, it all came back. And every time I told people shit, nobody, see, that's the fucking thing. Nobody does anything. It's like, what is a person like myself or other people out there, such as you, if you guys are even watching at this point, I need to start making legit videos, not this shit. What are we supposed to do? You know, what is a person supposed to do if they don't have insurance? And I've been in that situation where I didn't have insurance. I'd go to these doctors and they wouldn't do shit except put me down, whatever. I may have got saline, but that was about it. Nobody fucking did anything besides tens of thousands of dollars with the test. I mean, I'm probably $150,000 in debt, like legit debt, because of these pieces of shit doctors. Like, my credit's kind of somewhat getting better now with everything. I mean, there was a couple things I fucked up on, but, like, for the most part, all my stuff was medical bills. And then you got the cocksuckers that double bill your ass, like, they send your shit to the credit thing twice. But yeah, I think mine's still in the, I don't know, like 600s or so. Like, I think mid or high 600s. It's almost 700, so. I mean, it's a lot better than it was last year. But, yeah, a lot of stuff. But anyways, I gotta get off because this thing's literally about to kick me off. I got like a minute. But yeah, I don't get it. Doctors don't do shit. If you're broke, it's like, it is what it is. I don't know, you know, I personally say these piece of shit, just everybody needs to get off their ass and help people. I mean, like, if I could, I would. If I won the lottery, like a mass fucking fortune, I would help people. That's what I would do, you know, try to get myself healthy, but help people. And bring awareness, because I don't want people to feel like I have. But anyways, I'm going to get off, you know, this rant that I've been talking about. So I'm going to have to do that, log this thing on, and I think I got everything. I haven't died yet, so if this gets online, awesome. So, alright, I'm gonna get off. Just leave comments and whatever, and I wanna see if I can go eat something. I don't know. I did go to the store earlier. But, alright, cool. Loves you, dudes. Okay, that sounds gay. Love yous, peoples. Okay.